His dimensions, length, breadth, depth, time, space. Next to space is Nitya. Nitya is the sixth dimension. Then after that, Nadakala, Bindukala, all the other, totally 11 dimensions. The 11th is the Paramashiva, Swarupa, Paramashiva, Paramashivatva, Paramashiva, ultimate. The sixth dimension, Nitya, is easiness. That easiness's purest, almost 90% easiness is space. I should say 80% easiness is Kala, time. Alright, time is a poor word, but anyhow, I am using it. Kala, not the unit of time, time. So, be very clear. The whole humanity knows only unit of time, but not time itself. You may know the liter, but not about the milk. Don't misunderstand the measuring unit into measured content. The delusion of thinking, the measured content in the language of measuring unit led to the confusion that time is linear and it has past, present, future. Forget about it. Time is, it is neither static nor linear. It is existentially functioning. Understand? It's neither linear nor static. No, it is not static. Something which is dead, you can call it a static. It is not static and it is not linear. It is existentially alive. Like how life is alive in your whole body, in all dimensions. Life is not alive just inside your body, in your every action, in your every decision, and its impact on the others, world. That is why when you can impact more people, you feel more alive. Kala is existentially alive when length grows exponentially, it gives birth to breadth. When length, breadth grows exponentially, it gives birth to the dimension depth. When length, breadth, depth grows exponentially, it gives birth to the dimension Kala. And when length, breadth, depth, Kala, all of them grow exponentially, they give birth to space, dimension. The first principle I explained is some object, body, being, entity. Still in the breathing space of consciousness, but forgot its conscious nature. Movement of that body, being, entity is called karma. First principle. Second, listen. Kala does not have linear movement as we all understand as past, present, future. Time travel is simply possible for any being who prepares himself consciously. I'll make my Kayakalpa Yoga participants to do time travel and prove it. If I do it and show, you guys will not, you will say, oh, you are Paramashiva, you are enlightened. Nityananda haters will say, oh, he is doing some next drama, next level drama, jik magic, jack magic, jik magic, I don't know. I'll make you guys do it. I'll do it. I'm going to do. I'm not going to keep quiet. And I have not come down to planet Earth to keep quiet. I have come to reveal the truths of Kailas, Paramashiva's blessings. Come on, listen. The third principle, the second principle, when I explained, I revealed few more principles, like anything which is ease has to multiply. It's a very existence of easiness, ease multiplication. The quality of the easiness is ananda, and the quality of ananda is sharing. Understand? The quality of easiness, nitya, is ananda. Anything which is in you is always celebrates its existence. Somebody was asking me, what is exactly easiness, Swamiji? Other than your body, what you think as ease. See, you think you are body, you are your body. And there are something more you think you are. Because many time when you feel depression, you feel you are your mind. Excited, you feel you are your mind. So it is not that you feel you are only body. You feel many things are you. Other than your body, whatever you think as you, that is called your easiness. And that easiness, in its core, is excitement, bliss. And anything which is and which is bliss expands its existence. Even when you are depressed, you are enjoying your depression. Understand? Be very clear. You are enjoying your depression. You may have your own reasons. Listen to this one truth. Enjoying your depression, you will reproduce more depressed people. If you are enjoying your easiness, you will reproduce more easiness. If you are enjoying your sannyas, you will reproduce more sannyasis. That's it. Easiness celebrates its existence, and anything which celebrates its existence reproduces by its very nature. Death is nothing but a power given to every consciousness to reboot itself. By delete control, by self-cleaning mechanism, when the load of patterns, sufferings, depression, unconsciousness, negativity becomes too much. Listen.